Tinybird is all about speed. We believe in fast queries and faster developers. But nothing kills speed like trying to scan an entire 5 billion row table every time you call an endpoint. While Tinybird could probably handle that query faster than most, it's still a recipe for disaster. So in this screencast, I'll explain how to use materialized views to improve Tinybird endpoint performance, both in terms of speed and cost. Let's get after it. Okay, first, let me briefly explain how materialized views work in Tinybird, because it's a little different than what you might be used to. If you're coming from a traditional RDBMS, you're probably accustomed to having to manually trigger updates to materialized views. Not so with Tinybird. In Tinybird, a materialized view is a special data source created from the results of a pipe. What makes them so valuable is that the updates are triggered as soon as new data is ingested. This means you can move costly aggregations and filters to ingestion time instead of query time. If you build queries over materialized views, most often they'll scan fewer rows and take less time. Let's look at an example. Here we have a workspace with two data sources, one containing millions of rows of web events data from an e-commerce store, and the other with about 500 rows of product dimension data. And we have an API here that returns the total all-time revenue for a given product description. Now, this API is published from a series of SQL nodes that scans the entire events table and joins it to the products table every time it's called. Now, we can debate the merits of this SQL query and its efficiency, but the point is that this is expensive. If we call the API a few times, you can see that on average, it's processing about 700 megabytes of data with a latency of about 100 milliseconds. That's bad, especially since we have less than 10 million events in our data source. Can you imagine if we scaled to billions? Yikes. So, let's fix it. To do that, we're going to move all the filtering and aggregating to a materialized view, so it happens on ingestion, not when we make a request to the API. So first, let's copy that endpoint pipe and change the name to materialization pipe. If we look back at this pipe, we'll see that it's doing the filtering in the first node, the aggregating in the second, and the joining in the third. So what we're going to do is come down to the second node, and we're going to change this aggregation so it isn't grouped by day or city. So now it returns a total product revenue grouped by product ID. Let's materialize this. To create a materialized view, we click this node actions icon and select create materialized view from this node. Now we have the option to define the schema of the resulting data source. And since this one is pretty simple, it's only two columns, we'll just click next, populate with all existing data, and call the resulting data source total revenue MV. And now we have this new data source that's storing the results of the filter and aggregation as new data is being ingested. Now, let's update that endpoint to query from this new data source. So let's go to that final node and replace the reference to the prior node with a reference to the materialized view. Now we'll click run, and wait a sec, why did we get three rows of data? Well, this is due to the way that materialized views work in ClickHouse, which is the database that underpins Tinybird. Tinybird will store materialized aggregations in intermediate aggregated states and then occasionally merge them in the background every few minutes. To ensure that we get the final aggregation, we simply need to call the aggregating function again in the endpoint to force those states to merge in our final result. If that's confusing, don't worry. There's some nuance here, and I've linked to a Tinybird guide in the description below that does a very good job of explaining how this all works. So let's just add that aggregation function back in there, add our group by clause back to the statement, and then now if we call that endpoint, we can see that it's only processing about 100 kilobytes and responding much faster. Now, why didn't I put the join in the materialized view? The answer is that I could have, but joins in materialized views can get a little tricky, especially if the size of the table on the right side of the join grows. Now, my products table here has less than 500 rows, so it would have been absolutely no problem this time. But if that table were more like a million rows, I could run into some issues. Also, keep in mind that if you do have a join in a materialized pipe, the materialization process only gets triggered when the data source on the left side of the join updates. So if we added new products, we wouldn't be guaranteed that the materialization process would happen. The point is, if you're going to use a join in a materialization, you should make sure that your events data source is on the left side of the join. I've linked below to a Tinybird guide that explains in more detail why you should avoid big joins with materialized views and what you can do about it. And that's how you use materialized views to optimize your Tinybird endpoints. Now, again, there's some nuance here that we didn't get to. So if you have more questions about materialized views and how they work in Tinybird, you can find us in Slack or you can check out the docs. As I mentioned, I've linked to some resources below that I think will help. See you next time.